Yay! Yeah, yeah. Hey, everybody. I am excited about this video. This is one of my favorite things to talk about. It's one of my favorite things to yell out in the classroom. It's one of my favorite things to have kids see the magical use of. Today, we're talking about proportional relationships. So solving them. So setting up proportional relationships and solving them using a tool we call the thingy thang. So we're going to talk a lot about the thingy thang today. Hey, what did the cloud say to the lightning bolt? You're shot. Yep, it's a shocking lightning bolt. Okay, today we're going to talk about writing and solving a proportion that represents a proportional relationship between two quantities to find missing value, including problems in context. And yes, I will learn about the thing thang or the thingy thang. Okay, so let's just review proportional relationships real quick. This is simply two variables have a proportional relationship if the ratios of the variables are equivalent. All right, so what does that mean? Well, here's a ratio. Okay, let's just say we're talking about apples to oranges. I got two apples to every three oranges, and if it's proportional, it has to scale up or go up at the same rate. Okay, so it has to be proportional to scale up at the same rate. So the rate for the top of this, remember, when we talk about ratios and one way to figure out if they are proportional is they need to be equivalent fractions. And equivalent fractions need to scale up by the numerators at the same rate and by the denominators at the same rate. So this one, it scaled up by times 3 because 2 times 3 is 6. This one scaled up by times 3 because 3 times 3 is 9. So this, yeah, you guessed it. That's proportional. Okay, that's a proportional relationship. And this one, we got 1/5, and the other one is 4/16. Are they proportional? All right, well, the top we scaled up by 4, which means the bottom we need to scale up by, that's not 4. That's 3.2. So this is not proportional. Okay, these are just two ratios that don't compare similar proportions, or these are just two different fractions. Okay, so how do we set up proportions? This is what's big. So you're going to get... Sometimes proportions will be set up for you, but most of the time, especially if we're using proportions in the real world, you're going to have a scenario or something in context where you need to look at it and set up the proportion. Okay, so remember, they compare two or more ratios. And if it's going to be proportional, they have to be equivalent fractions. All right, remember that? Have to be equivalent fractions. And what makes them equivalent? The numerators scale up at the same rate as the denominators. Okay. So setting up proportions, it's all about the labels, yo. Come on, bruh. So let's look at this one. 7 biscuits cost $9.50. How much does 4 biscuits cost? Okay, so we're not going to solve this, but we're just going to work on setting it up, and we're going to be focused on labels, okay? Because there's about 4 different ways we can set this bad boy up. Okay, the first one would be, let's take what we know, okay? We know there are 7 biscuits, and they cost $9.50, okay? So I went ahead and put that into my initial ratio, okay? Initial ratio, okay? And we're going to set it equal to whatever we're trying to solve because we're using proportional relationships. And whatever we're trying to solve is we know we have 4 biscuits, but we don't know how much it costs, okay? So when I say it's all about the labels, the top of both fractions is biscuits. So we put them across from each other. And the bottom of each one of these ratios is the cost, okay? And you can flip it over as well. You can say $9.50 per 7 biscuits. And we can, as long as we flip over the other one as well and put, we don't know how much it costs over $4, which means we put the cost on top and we put biscuits on the bottom. Those are the most common ways. That's the way I like to set them up. But you can also get a little tricky and try it this way. Okay. So this one, we have 7 biscuits over 4 biscuits. So we put the biscuits on the top and the bottom of the first ratio. And we're setting it equal to the cost of both of the scenarios, okay? So what's the labels we're doing there? Well, $7.950 is our first ratio. And ratio number 2 is over here, $4 per cost. But also noticed that when we did that, we have them across from each other, okay? We have them across from each other. So ratio 1 is all in one line. Ratio 2 is all in one line. But also notice that, let me clear that up, ratio 1 is all in one line, but biscuits are over biscuits and cost are over cost, okay? All right, so we could also just flip that over and put biscuits on the left, cost on the right, but the top is ratio 2 and the bottom is ratio one. So that's very, very specific, but the main thing you need to understand is that it is, yes, it is all about the labels. And the labels are putting things together based on the ratios in the labels, okay? All right, so let's set up some proportions. Look about this one. Same type of thing. Sometimes we're comparing parts to wholes, okay? So let's take a recipe. A recipe uses 2 cups of milk to make 20 cookies. How many cups of milk are needed for 80 cookies? Okay, well, there's different setups here. This time we're thinking about part to whole, okay? And so in our first initial ratio, our part is going to be the 2 cups of milk because that's part of a recipe, right? So we're gonna put that up top. We're gonna put part over whole is equal to part over whole. So remember, it's all about the labels. So our first ratio gave us 2 cups of milk, which that's our part, over 20 cookies, because that's the whole batch. So 2/20, okay? We're gonna set it equal to, what's the part of the next scenario? Well, how many cups of milk are needed for 80 cookies? Well, cups of milk goes together because that's the part. So up top would be the unknown because we don't know how many cups of milk we have. And the bottom would be 80 because when we make this 80 cookies, that's gonna be the whole batch of cookies, okay? These could also be flipped over, okay? We could have done These could also be flipped over. So this could, if you imagine both of these flipped over, like the last scenario that we did, you could have done that. So it could have been 20/2 equals 80/x. Okay, so another way we can do this is to look at it and say part/part is equal to whole/whole. But remember, we gotta line up our ratios together. Okay, so 2 is our part of the first scenario and x is the part of our second scenario. So that's the part/part. And we're gonna make it equal to whole/whole. Now the reason 20 is on the top over here is because it goes with the 2. Okay, and then the 80 is on the bottom because it goes with the x. And we could have flipped these over. It could have been x/2 equals 80/20. Doesn't matter as long as the labels are all put together, okay? Now, everything and all my videos I've had so far, when we look at unit rate, we look at ratio tables, and we look at proportions, we've kind of focused on really thinking about that rate, right? So one way to solve proportions is to think about that rate. What did I do to get from 20 to 80? Well, I multiplied by 4, which means the top, I have to multiply by 4. That's the rate, okay? And what is 2 times 4? It is 8. So that's how we would have solved for x, okay? Now, sometimes they are much larger numbers and complicated rates. So sometimes you might be multiplying by pi on top and bottom, and that becomes much more difficult to deal with. Or you might have massive quantities in here, and you don't want to try to figure out what those numbers are. So that's where we get to the point of this slide. Now we get to use our understanding of one-step equations. Remember, you have worked on one-step equations where you may have something like 3x equals 9, and we knew that this is a one-step equation because we said this is 3 times x, which means we are going to do the inverse, and we are going to divide by 3 on both sides, and that gives us x equals 9 divided by 3 is 3. Do you remember doing all that? I hope so. If not, go back and check out that video. But we get to focus on how we solve one-step equations and the coolest tool ever. Is the thingy thing. Well, the thingy thing is a method, a way of solving proportions. It's kind of a trick. As long as we understand how proportional reasoning works and you understand how to go by the same rate up and down, on the top and bottom by either multiplying or dividing. We don't use addition or subtraction. The thingy thing is a method to make these a little easier. So let's go back to this problem. 7 biscuits cost $8.75. How much does 4 biscuits cost? So the first step in any of these is setting up our proportion. And we just did that with 2 different problems. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna say we have 7 biscuits that cost $8.75, and we're gonna set up our proportion on the other side by making sure our labels are in the same spot. So on the top, we're gonna have 4 biscuits cost the unknown. We don't know how much it costs, so that's on the bottom. So the top is how many biscuits, the bottom is total cost, okay? So that's the first step, done. Thingy thang, step 1 completed. Step 2, this is where the thingy thang really takes shape. You cross multiply. When I say cross multiply, that means look diagonally across the 2 ratios. And you take this one, for example, 4 times $8.75 or $8.75 times 4, and you multiply them. Okay, in this case, you get 35. Then you go the other way. You cross multiply the other diagonal that we didn't do the first one, and that would be 7 times C, or C times 7. It doesn't matter because it gives you the same answer of 7C. When you multiply a variable by a coefficient or by a number, you're going to get, just take that number and put it right next to it because it means 7 times C. Now, step 3, set them equal to each other. Set what equal to each other? Well, take your two answers. I had 35 and I had 7C. Set them equal to each other. And it could have done it the other way as well. It could have been 7C equals 35. Don't panic. Just set them equal to each other, whichever way works best for you. And then the final one, step 4, is to divide both sides by the coefficient. And we got to remember what a coefficient is. What is a coefficient? A coefficient is that number that is being multiplied or divided by the variable. So the coefficient is the number with the variable. So in this situation, we're going to divide both sides by 7. And what do you get? 7 divided by 7 cancels out. 35 divided by 7 is 5. And so C equals 5. Okay, C equals 5. Well, what was C all about anyway? In this situation, it was the cost of 4 biscuits. So 4 biscuits cost $5. So really, these are the steps. Steps 2, 3, and 4 are the steps. And as you get good at it, you're just going to say to yourself over and over, cross multiply and divide. Cross multiply and divide. All right, let's do one more. Okay, the total weight of 15 desks is 45 pounds. How much will 40 desks weigh? Well, step 1, set up your proportion. I have 15 desks is 45 pounds. Okay, and the other, and so we're going to set it equal to our other part, which was how much does 40 desks weigh? Our desks in the first scenario are on the top. So on the other scenario, we want to put the desks on the top as well, and that was 40. It's all about the labels. And what we don't know is the weight of the desks, okay? So one of them weighed 45 pounds in our first one, and the second ratio, we don't know. Step 2, cross multiply. What's 45 times 40? This is where you get your calculator or whatever method works best for you, and you will multiply, and you will get an answer. And then you will do the other diagonal multiplication, 15 times D, and you will get 15D. Step 3 says just set those two answers equal to each other. And here they come, 1800 divided by 15D. Guess what? Divide both sides by the coefficient. This time the coefficient is 15. Let's divide by 15. What's 15 divided by 15? Well, that cancels out into 1, gives us 1D, which is just D. And 1800 divided by 15 is 120. So when we cross multiplied, we found out D equals 120. And what does D equal? Well, that means 40 desks weigh 120 pounds because D represented the weight of 40 desks. It's the thingy thing, y'all. We're going to use this so much. As long as you have a thorough understanding of what proportional reasoning means and how to find, set up proportions and solve them using proportional reasoning, I'm fine with you learning a trick now and again. And the thingy thing is a cool tool in your tool belt or a little trick on how to get to those answers. Set up the proportion, cross multiply, set them equal to each other, and divide. It's called, say it with me, the thingy thing. All right, fill in the blank time. The thingy thing is a way to solve proportions. Solving proportion step 1 is to set up the proportion correctly. Number 3, after you set up the proportion, you cross multiply. That was step 2, but it was number 3. So step 3 is to set them equal to each other. So after you cross multiply and you got your two answers, set them equal to each other. And then step 4 is to divide both sides by the coefficient. Oh, the thingy thing. You are going to thank me. You're going to thank me. You're probably going to send me messages. You're just going to be like, this thingy thing is the cat's meow. All right. What did the beaver say to the tree? It's been nice gnawing on you. Instead of knowing you, gnawing you. Let's go. All right. Giddy up.